Hello dear students, last class we have discussed about dispersion of light and dispersive power and angular dispersion. So we know that when a white light is made to pass through the prism, then that white light splits into 7 constituent colors. That phenomenon is known as dispersion of light. And during that instant, you may see the refraction of different light rays. When white light is made to pass through the prism, that means in case of this dispersion, different colors are going to deviate at different extents. Not all the colors are going to move in a same path, especially when that composite light or white light is made to pass through the prism. The phenomenon at which the different light rays, that means different light rays in the sense with respect to wavelength or with respect to frequency, those light rays are going to deviate at different extents. This phenomenon is known as refringability. So note on this definition, refringability. During dispersion, of light, different colors because composite light splits into 7 constituent colors. For that reason we are going to use this word different colors. Or deviate at different extents. So this phenomenon is known as refringability of light. So on the basis of this only we are going to say different colors are going to deviate at different extents, in the sense least deviating color is different and most deviating color is different, like that. So we know that in case of prism, least deviation is for red and most deviation is for violet. And today we are going to discuss a few more important and interesting concepts regarding refraction, dispersion, and also internal reflection. Depending upon these phenomena, we can explain various interesting concepts which are taking place in our day-to-day life. For example, during rainy season we can observe a rainbow. So why we are going to see those colors in the rainbow? What is the reason behind that? And sometimes clouds are white in color. So what is the reason behind that? And most commonly we are going to observe a reddish sun during sunrise and sunset. So usually we know that sun appears reddish during sunrise and sunset. See here, we can explain these all phenomena on the basis of refraction, dispersion, as well as internal reflection. Let us see one by one. The first one, formation of a rainbow. What is the meaning of a rainbow? So usually we know that during a rainy season, not in a summer, during a rainy season, we can observe some color bands in the sky. The color band is nothing but it is also spectrum. So that spectrum is known as a rainbow. So what is the cause for that spectrum in the atmosphere? So that is the important concept here. See here, when sunlight or composite light propagates through the Earth's atmosphere, it passes through air droplets, water droplets, not air droplets, water droplets, or we can say rain droplets. So here each rain droplet acts as a optical medium. It is made up of liquid molecules. When that sunlight propagates through a rain droplet, then that sunlight undergoes a refraction, dispersion, and also internal reflection. Due to this reason, we can observe different colors in the rainbow. And also, while observing the rainbow, unknowingly we are going to maintain some procedures. We will not observe the rainbow like this. So we are going to observe the rainbow at a particular angle, especially this direction lies between 42 and 40 degree. Within this angle we can observe the band of colors in the sky. So that is known as a rainbow. Now, what are the conditions to observe the rainbow? So first of all, this rainbow is the combined effect of refraction, dispersion, and internal reflection of light. When sunlight propagates through the water droplet, rain droplet, when white light propagates through the rain droplet, it splits into constituent colors. Again, these colors undergo internal reflection as well as refraction. And this causes group of colors, band of colors. So that is known as a rainbow. So let us note down the definition for a rainbow. It is the combined effect of refraction, dispersion, and internal reflection. Of sunlight don't write O instead of U. Sunlight. By the rain droplets. So it is known as a rainbow. It is the combined effect of refraction, dispersion, and internal reflection of sunlight by the rain droplets. Try to understand, I am not writing total internal reflection. It is not due to total internal reflection, it is just due to internal reflection. I will explain how internal reflection takes place in each rain droplet. And what are the conditions to observe this rainbow? The first condition, a rainbow appears during rainfall or after the rainfall. Don't try to observe the rainbow in summer season. So let us note on the conditions to observe a rainbow. Conditions. Condition to observe. First one, a rainbow appears during a rainfall or after the rainfall. So during rainfall or after the rainfall means there is a humidity in the atmosphere. So again, that humidity contains liquid droplets. So during rainfall, after the rainfall, each droplets acts as a prism. We know that when white light is made to pass through the prism, then that white light splits into 7 colors. Similarly, so during rainfall or after the rainfall, each liquid droplet, see here, each liquid droplet acts as a prism. Except air or vacuum, we can observe dispersion of light. So when white light is made to pass through this liquid droplet, then this white light splits into 7 colors. And finally, those colors emerge out of this rain droplet, and that creates a band of colors in the sky. So, first condition to observe rainbow, appears during the rainfall or after the rainfall. And second condition, the observer or the back of the observer must be towards the sun or we can say that is sun is shining. On one part of the sky, and while raining, in the opposite part of the sky. See, the back of the observer must be towards the sun. If I am going to observe the rainbow in this direction, you just imagine yourself. This is the sun. The back of the observer must be towards the sun. So we should do weave like this. And there should be a rainfall exactly in opposite part of the sky. So during this condition, we can observe the rainbow. These are the major two conditions to observe spectrum of light in the sky. Okay. So these are the conditions. Then there are two types in rainbow. The first one is primary rainbow and the second one is secondary rainbow. In both the cases, we can observe these phenomena, that is refraction, dispersion, and internal reflection of light. So let us observe the phenomena, so which is taking place in case of primary rainbow and secondary rainbow. Types of rainbow. The first one is primary rainbow and second one is secondary rainbow. Okay. So let us observe the phenomena which is taking place in case of primary rainbow. First one, primary rainbow. Let us consider a water droplet. So this is a water droplet. I'm going to consider a single water droplet in order to explain this phenomenon. When a white light is made to pass through this water droplet or a rain droplet, so here each rain droplet acts as a prism. So when white light is made to pass through this prism or water droplet, then that white light splits into seven colors. So let us consider incident light ray. Incident light ray, that is composite light, direction of composite light or white light. Then when this droplet acts as a prism, then this white light splits into 7 colors. First refracted light ray. Direction of a refracted light ray. Another refracted light ray. I am going to highlight only 2 colors, that is red and violet, and remaining colors lies between these 2 segments. So one is a least deviation, another one is maximum deviation. So normal at the point of incidence. So this is the normal at the point of incidence. When this angle of incidence, see here, for this interface, these 2 refracted light rays acts as incident light rays. When this angle is greater than critical angle, then these 2 light rays undergo internal reflection, not total internal reflection. Because there is a loss in intensity of light. For that reason, I am not going to consider that term total. It is just internal reflection. Even though in case of internal reflection, we are going to follow the same conditions as in case of total internal reflection. Light ray tends to travel from denser to rarer. Here, denser to rarer. If angle of incidence is greater than critical angle, then these 2 light rays undergo reflection. That is internal reflection. Greater than critical angle for air and water, because a rain droplet is nothing but liquid droplet. We know that sin C, n is equal to 1 divided by sin C. By substituting refractive index of water, it is made up of water, that is 1.33. Then we will get C is equal to 48 degree. This 48 degree is critical angle for water-air interface. When this angle is greater than 48 degree, then these 2 light rays undergo internal reflection. So let us consider internal reflection. Direction of a reflected light ray. Another reflected light ray. Then these 2 light rays emerge out of this rain droplet. So red appears at an angle of 42 degree with respect to direction of incident light. So here this angle is 42 degree and this angle is 40 degree. For an observer,
by proceeding these two light rays in backward direction. By proceeding these two light rays in backward direction, red appears at the top and violet appears at the bottom. And remaining colors lies between these two light rays. That means in case of this primary rainbow, for an observer, red appears at the top and violet appears at the bottom. That means in the case of primary rainbow, always at the top we will get red, at the bottom of the spectrum we will get violet. So red appears at an angle 42 degree and violet appears at an angle 40 degree with respect to direction of incident light. And in case of this primary rainbow, intensity of rainbow is more as compared with the secondary rainbow. So let us consider the phenomena which is taking place in case of a secondary rainbow. Secondary rainbow. So when a sunlight is made to pass through this rain droplet, white light, direction of white light or sunlight, then this light ray undergoes a refraction and also dispersion. Direction of a refracted light ray. Again, I am going to consider only two colors, that is least deviation and for maximum deviation, red and violet. Another refracted light ray. Direction of a refracted light ray. So these two refracted light rays acts as incident light rays for the water air interface, for this interface. Normal at the point of incidence, if this angle is greater than critical angle, this angle of incidence is greater than critical angle, as like as in case of primary rainbow, when I is greater than C, let us say this angle is I,
then these two light rays undergo internal reflection.
Direction of a reflected light ray, internal reflection. Direction of a reflected light ray.
Again, normal at the point of incidence.
Normal at the point of incidence.
These two reflected light rays acts as incident light rays for this interface. If this angle is greater than critical angle, again these two light rays undergo internal reflection.
Internal reflection, direction of a reflected light ray. Direction of a reflected light ray.
Then from a denser to rarer, it bends away from the light. Away from the normal, and finally these two light rays emerge out of this rain droplet. Direction of a refracted light ray.
Direction of a refracted light ray.
So we can observe these two light rays in the secondary rainbow. Red appears at an angle of 53 degrees. And violet appears at an angle of 50 degrees. Now for an observer, by proceeding these two light rays in backward direction,
so in case of a secondary rainbow, violet appears at the top and red appears at the bottom, and the remaining colors lies between violet and red.
So here, in case of primary rainbow, red appears at the top, violet appears at the bottom. In case of secondary rainbow,
violet appears at the top and a red appears at the bottom. This is the rare case, that is a secondary rainbow. So in general, what we are going to observe, that is primary rainbow. So you might have seen in that primary rainbow, at the top of the rainbow, we can observe red color. See here, in that, even though in case of primary rainbow, all the seven colors are not clearly visible. For that reason, we are going to use the term only internal reflection, not total internal reflection. So when we are going to say total means, there is no loss in intensity. But in case of rainbow, there is a loss in intensity of light. So primary rainbow, you just observe these two ray diagrams. Primary rainbow, that is due to two refractions, refraction, internal reflection, refraction. So this phenomena is due to two refraction, one internal reflection. This phenomena is due to two refractions and two internal reflection. Or we can say this one is three step phenomena, this one is four step phenomena. So in your examination, they may ask to write the difference between primary rainbow and secondary rainbow. So if you want, you can note down the differences between primary rainbow and secondary rainbow. Primary rainbow. Secondary rainbow. So here this one is white light or sunlight. So easily we can write the differences between a primary rainbow and a secondary rainbow. First one, in case of a primary rainbow, so this is due to two refractions and one internal reflection. First one. It is due to two refractions and one internal reflection. Don't write total internal, it is just internal reflection. And in case of secondary rainbow, the first point, it is due to two refractions and 2 internal reflections. Of sunlight by the rain droplets. Second one, a red appears at the top and violet appears at the bottom. Of the spectrum. Rainbow is nothing but spectrum. And in case of secondary rainbow, violet appears at the top. And a red appears at the bottom of the spectrum. Third difference. Red appears at an angle of 42 degree, violet appears at an angle of 40 degree with respect to direction of incident light. A red appears at an angle of 42 degree. For that reason only, while observing the rainbow, we are going to use this direction. So we are going to view in between 40 and 42 degree, we will get a primary rainbow. By observing between these two angles, we can observe primary rainbow. It appears at an angle of 42 degree and violet appears at an angle of 40 degree with respect to direction of incident light. And in case of secondary rainbow, red appears at an angle of 53 degree and violet appears at an angle of 50 degree with respect to incident
light. So in case of primary rainbow, intensity is more. In case of secondary rainbow, intensity is less. Fourth one. Less intensity. So here, sorry, not less intensity, primary rainbow, more intensity. So here, less intensity. So here intensity is more, here intensity is less. So these are the differences between primary rainbow and secondary rainbow. If you want one more, you can write primary rainbow is 1, 2, 3, three stop phenomena. Secondary rainbow 1, 2, 3, 4, four step of phenomena. Primary rainbow. So this one is a three step phenomena. Now this one is four step phenomena. Don't get confusion, this one is primary, this one is secondary. Primary, rainbow. So this one is secondary rainbow. Colorful diagrams are not required in your examination. Only for highlighting the concept, I am going to use the color chalk piece here. And another two concepts depending upon deviation of colors. So in general, sky appears blue in color. What is the reason behind that? We know that white light is made up of 7 constituent colors. So among these 7 colors, minimum wavelength is for violet and maximum wavelength is for red. This sunlight or white light in the atmosphere is scattered by the particles of the atmosphere. Particles of the atmosphere means dust particles, air particles, water droplets, humidity, etc. During this instant, again that composite light undergoes dispersion. That means it splits into 7 colors. During this instant, few colors are going to reach the earth's surface. For example, in a Vibhzayar, wavelength is minimum for violet, then indigo, then blue. That means blue color scatters with a high intensity. Violet, indigo, and also blue color scatter with a high intensity. But our human eye is very sensitive for blue color. And hence our eye clearly identify that blue color instead of violet and indigo. For this reason, sky appears blue in color. And also, we know that sun appears reddish during sunrise and sunset. See, in these two cases, sun is far away from us. That means light propagates from longer distance. During this instant, colors of minimum wavelength, they scatters with a high intensity, and those colors move away from our line of sight. The least deviated colors are going to reach the observer. Least deviation is for red, orange. And hence during sunrise and sunset, we can observe sun is reddish. So that is due to this phenomena. So let us see these two phenomena on the basis of a change in intensity of light. So these two phenomena basically due to scattering of light. Now, what is the meaning of this scattering? Change in path of the sunlight by the particles of the medium is known as scattering of light. Next concept, scattering of light. So scattering of light, in another way, we can say, let us consider a particle in the atmosphere. So this is the particle in the atmosphere.
when the sunlight is pass through this particle, then that light, the direction of that light is may change when that light is made to pass through this particle. Incident light, direction of incident light. Scattered light, direction of scattered light. Change in the direction of sunlight by the particles of the medium, that phenomenon is known as scattering of light. Or else we can write, you just view this diagram. It appears as if this particle first absorbs the light ray. Then it re-emits the light. First absorption of light, then re-emission of light. During this case only, there is a change in path of light in the atmosphere. The absorption and re-emission, the absorption and re-emission of light by the particles of the medium is known as scattering of light. So let us know the definition of scattering of light. The absorption and re-emission of sunlight by the particles of the medium. Is known as scattering. So there are two types in scattering of light. The first one is coherent scattering and the second one is incoherent scattering. See here, if suppose wavelength of this incident light is lambda 1 and wavelength of this scattered light is lambda 2. Sometimes lambda 1 is equal to lambda 2. Sometimes lambda 1 is not equal to lambda 2. There is a chance the wavelength of incident light is equal to wavelength of scattered light. In some other situation, there may be a chance to say wavelength of incident light is not equal to wavelength of scattered light. When wavelength of incident light is equal to wavelength of scattered light, then such type of scattering is known as coherent scattering. If wavelength of incident light is not equal to wavelength of scattered light, not equal to in the sense lambda 1 may be greater than lambda 2 or lambda 1 may be less than lambda 2, like that, then such type of scattering is known as incoherent scattering. Types of scattering: first one, coherent scattering. So coherent scattering means so here wavelength of scattered light or wavelength of incident light wavelength of scattered light is same as that of incident light. So this is known as coherent scattering. Example for coherent scattering is Rayleigh scattering. Rayleigh's Rayleigh apostrophe S Rayleigh's scattering. So Rayleigh's scattering. So in this scattering, the wavelength of incident light is equal to wavelength of scattered light. So here Rayleigh scattering is nothing but coherent scattering. And second one, incoherent scattering. Incoherent scattering. So wavelength of scattered light is not equal to wavelength, not equal, or you can say different. Wavelength of scattered light is different or not equal to, is different as that of incident light. So example for incoherent scattering is Raman scattering. So Raman scattering is incoherent scattering. So according to this case, the wavelength of a scattered light is different as that of incident light. Sometimes in competitive examination they may ask incoherent scattering. Option number 1, lambda 1 is greater than lambda 2. Option number 2, lambda 1 is less than lambda 2. Option number 3, lambda 1 is equal to lambda 2. Option number 4, none of these. Then in case of coherent scattering, your answer is lambda 1 is equal to lambda 2. Wavelength of incident light is equal to wavelength of scattered light. Then Rayleigh's law.
So according to this Rayleigh's law, so Rayleigh scattering means here wavelength of scattered light is equal to wavelength of incident light. Now Rayleigh's law, according to this Rayleigh's law, intensity of scattered light is inversely proportional to fourth power of wavelength present in the scattered light. That means intensity and wavelength are inversely proportional according to this law. So note on the Rayleigh's law statement, the intensity of scattered light is inversely proportional to fourth power of wavelength in the scattered light. Then according to this statement, let us say I be the intensity. The intensity is inversely proportional to fourth power of wavelength of light present in the scattered light. On the basis of this, we can explain why sky appears blue in color and why sun appears reddish during sunrise and sunset. So here intensity is inversely proportional to fourth power of wavelength of light. The fourth power of wavelength present in the scattered light. Sky appears blue in color. So what is the reason behind this? So when a white light or composite light is passed through the atmosphere, then that white light undergoes dispersion. So during dispersion, that white light splits into seven colors. So we know that among these seven colors, wavelength is minimum, lambda minimum for violet,
lambda maximum for red.
So during daytime, when the light is made to pass through the atmosphere, it undergoes dispersion. So during dispersion, the color of minimum wavelength, that is violet, indigo, blue, especially violet has minimum wavelength, but it is not sensitive for the human eye, will not recognize this color. Similarly, indigo, then human eye is sensitive for a blue color. Therefore, by neglecting these two colors, among these five colors, wavelength is minimum for blue. Wavelength is minimum for blue. And hence, blue color scatters with high intensity. We know that relation between intensity and wavelength. So blue color is sensitive for the human eye. For that reason, I am going to consider blue color and I am going to neglect violet and indigo. Therefore, this color scatters with high intensity. Scatters with high intensity. And hence sky appears blue in color. Remaining colors also undergo scattering, but they scatter with less intensity as compared with blue. Therefore, among these five colors, we will receive this color. And hence, sky appears blue in color. So that is the reason behind this. So during daytime, white light undergoes dispersion. Sunlight undergoes dispersion in the atmosphere. During this instant, light of minimum wavelength scatters with high intensity. Among seven colors, human eye is sensitive for blue color. And hence, blue color
scatters with high intensity. Therefore, sky appears blue in color.
That is due to scattering of light. But according to Rayleigh's law, during scattering process, intensity is inversely proportional to wavelength of light, and hence blue color scatters with high intensity, and hence the sky appears blue in color in daytime. Then sun appears reddish during sunrise and sunset. Sun appears reddish during sunrise and sunset. So during sunrise and sunset, sun is far away from us. That means light propagates from the longer distance. Just imagine yourself, observer on the earth surface. Sunrise or sunset during sunrise and sunset, light propagates from longer distance. Sun is far away from us. During this instant, when a light undergoes dispersion in the atmosphere, again that light splits into 7 constituent colors. Among those 7 colors, least deviation is for red and next for orange. Then remaining colors scatters with high intensity, and those colors move away from line of sight. We are not identify those colors. That means from sun we are going to receive red and orange. That means these two colors are least deviating colors as compared with the remaining colors. The remaining colors scatters with more intensity and they move away from line of sight. See here, violet move away from line of sight. Then blue move away from line of sight. Yellow move away from line of sight.
the least deviation for red and orange. These two colors reach the observer. That means these colors undergo scattering and they are going to scatter with a high intensity. Even we can identify those colors. Especially these two colors, that means wavelength of these two colors, orange and red, maximum. But they are going to scatter with less intensity. And also least deviation for these two colors. Maximum deviation, and also these colors are going to scatter with high intensity, and hence they are going to move away from line of sight. We cannot identify those colors. Therefore, we are going to receive only red and orange during sunrise and sunset. They are going to deviate with a less intensity. With less intensity, for that reason we are going to enjoy sunset and sunrise. So that is the reason behind this. Again, this is due to scattering of light. Once again here, intensity is inversely proportional to wavelength of light. So during sunrise and sunset, during sunrise and sunset, sunlight propagates from longer distance. The colors with a high intensity. Colors with high intensity means violet, indigo, blue, gray, yellow. The colors with a high intensity deviate more and they move away from line of sight. The least deviated colors that is red and orange, reach the observer reach the observer. With less intensity. Because I is inversely proportional to wavelength, fourth power of wavelength. Less intensity. Hence, sun appears reddish during sunrise and sunset. Scatters with high intensity, because here if you want you can write I is inversely proportional to fourth power of wavelength of light. Okay, so in next class, we shall discuss a few more interesting concepts.